Welcome to King's Cross Station, Central London. Today I'm travelling with LNER on board their brand new Azuma train from London King's Cross to Hull in their first class carriage. My first class ticket granted me entry to the first class lounge for LNER here at London King's Cross. It is found within the main terminal concourse prior to entering the platforms. London King's Cross also offers plenty of other facilities, including restaurants, shops and cafes. The lounge is located upstairs, and to access it, you need to go via a lift. My first impressions of the lounge were good, and there was plenty of places to sit. There were plenty of advertisements around the station for the new Azuma trains. The lounge offered a wide range of hot drinks, cold drinks and snacks. There were some good views of the platforms from the lounge. The lounge is self-service and you can help yourself to snacks and drinks whenever you like. The lounge exits straight onto the bridge over the platforms. The walk to platform 3 takes just a couple of minutes, where our train departs from today. One thing I did notice with the new Azuma is that the livery is quite simplistic and in my opinion it is quite boring. I was seated in coach K today in seat 10, which is split between both standard class and first class. I immediately noticed when boarding the train that first class no longer has leather seats. On our table was two cups and a first class menu for today's service. As I was travelling on a Saturday, this did mean that unfortunately I wouldn't be served a hot meal on board the train. However, there still was a fairly good choice of snacks on board.
Hello, and welcome on board this LNER Azuma to Hull. We will call at Peterborough, Grantham, Newark Northgate, Doncaster, Selby, Brough, and Hull.
Do you remember a Snapchat when you could only write on one line? When you used to only be able to write?
I thought you meant like messages on those.
What
first drink service was a cold drink service, and I was served with an orange juice, and this happened around 10 minutes after departure from King's Cross. The onboard host offered this deli box or a salmon sandwich and a raspberry and apple slice along with a soft drink. Unfortunately, around 15 minutes after departure from King's Cross, the train encountered a technical fault. One of the brakes on board was faulty and needed to be isolated before we could continue our journey any further. We spent around 20 minutes at a standstill before continuing on to Peterborough. The train manager was very, very informative and gave us lots of information about what was happening and how long we could expect our delay to be. Just as we started moving again, the onboard host passed through with the first serving of hot drinks. I opted for a hot chocolate, as I'm not a massive fan of tea and coffee.
Hello, and welcome on board this LNER Azuma to Hull.
I travelled on standard class on the Azuma earlier on in the day, and although the legroom is good, unfortunately the seats are a little bit uncomfortable and they are quite hard. The onboard host passed through with another cold drink service. And just before arriving into Grantham, another hot drink service. As the journey between Grantham and Newark Northgate was only around 10 minutes, this meant that there was no time for the onboard team to serve any snacks and drinks.
Mark.
We are now at Doncaster.
What should it be here now?
What time should it be at Doncaster?
19th floor. Yeah, platform 4. Sure. This one is behind us. So as long as it doesn't...
Most of the onboard team leave the train at Doncaster, meaning that there was no refreshments served between Doncaster and Hull. Unfortunately, we got held up again between Doncaster and Selby, which did mean that the train was now running more than 40 minutes late.
Thank you.
The doors at the rear of this coach will not be opening at the next station.
We'll be exiting the Leeds.
To ensure I didn't miss my connection at Hull, I moved right to the other end of the train, which would be nearest the station when I arrived. You can see the standard coach as we move through the train.
Thank you.
Welcome to Hull Paragon Interchange. If I were to travel on the Azuma again, I'm not actually sure if I would upgrade to first class. It is nice having complimentary refreshments on board the train, however, in my opinion, it's not worth the extra money upgrading from those standard seats to the first class seats. I do think that the new first class coach on board the Azuma trains is a little bit disappointing, especially compared to their LNER'S old first class coach. However, it is nice having access to somewhere quiet to sit before your train departs. It's nice to see Hull getting some brand new trains, and it's also good to see LNER supporting the Hull route. Thank you so much for watching this video, I do hope you've enjoyed. If you are new to the channel, please check out some of my other videos and remember to subscribe.